Hello, and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we'll take a look at the SQL JSON features in Postgres 15. Postgres 15 will most likely be released September or October, so it's still quite a way until we can actually use this on a production server. However, a couple of days ago, the Postgres 15 feature phrase occurred, and so that means we now have a good sense for which functionality will make it into this next Postgres release. One of the features is the new SQL JSON functionality. Dipesh wrote about this on his blog. First of all, is the new SQLJSON constructor syntax. One of the new features here is that you can use the with unique key syntax to ensure that a JSON document does not have any duplicate keys. For example, you have a key A and a key B, and it's going to process it successfully. Now, if you pass a key A and another key A, then it will error out saying you have duplicate key values. Generally, Postgres has been more permissive in this regard. For example, if you have JSON B data, JSON B internally would only store one of the two keys. It's very good to validate your data here early so that you don't store data incorrectly. Closely related to constructor syntax is the new isJSON predicate to check if a certain value is a valid JSON value. We can say of the data that we stored in our table, does it have unique keys or does it not have unique keys? And this might be useful if you have existing JSON data sets where you're trying to understand, do they conform to these requirements or not? Additionally, there is new functionality for working with JSON path expressions. JSON path expressions already exist in Postgres, and important to note is that JSON path only works on JSON B data types, not JSON. And that's because Postgres treats a JSON data type as text, whereas JSON B has a logical structure to it. Now, we have a document with a key A, and so I can check for the existence of a particular key in this document. If I check whether there is a key B, you can see that that returns false. Where it is really useful is for check constraints. I can now conveniently use this JSON exists function on, for example, this addresses JSON B document. And so I can validate that there is a main key present, and if it wasn't present, then you couldn't insert the data into this table. It would actually reject the data because of that check constraint. Now, my favorite new JSON feature in Postgres 15. JSONTABLE lets you work with a JSON structure in Postgres as if it was a regular Postgres table. You can see here, we have our A and our B keys, and it's essentially a array of hashes, very typical JSONB data. Now, we have this JSON path expression, and this tells us how to interpret this document as a table. In addition to that, you have this new columns keyword. And the columns keyword indicates that I'm creating a in-memory Postgres table, and the table has a column underscore A that maps to the JSON path key A, and then the column B that maps to the JSON path column B in our result set. We're using this like a set returning function, so we say select star from and this JSON table expression, and then the result looks like as if we created a regular Postgres table. That's, of course, very useful because now you can do all kinds of other transformations, aggregations, and such on this JSON data as if it was a regular Postgres table that you're working with. There is some additional convenience functions. For example, I can use this for ordinality syntax to get one value for each row in the document. Useful if you want to have something you can identify each row with. This syntax automatically detects when a column is named the same way. So I'm declaring a column here with an E4 data type called A, and then we already have a JSON key called A that automatically matches. You don't need to do any extra work and write a lot of JSON path expressions in those cases. Last but not least, there is a really neat feature here which lets you work with nested data as well. For example, we have an array of hashes. These are blog posts, and each of the blog posts also has comments. In a nested structure like this, if you want to work with it, there's a new nested path keyword for JSON table, and that lets you break down further as if you're doing a join on two tables. The top level data gets repeated, and then the individual comments here are unique. So again, this just makes it very convenient to work with complex documents. If you want to learn more about this, you can also see the JSON table documentation in the development snapshot of the Postgres documentation. As you can see, I'm very excited about Postgres 15. This was 5 Minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episodes, and see you next week.